Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo. Friends, today we are going to learn a tutorial on calculating the IRR in Excel. So as you can see over here, there are a couple of things that input, that is minus 3000, 2000 and 5000. So this is in negative, the rest two are in positive, and you put all of them so that you can get an IRR. So basically IRR is just the value and the guess. Let's begin how this thing works. See, IRR in Excel stands for internal rate of return, right? This is as simple as that. Internal rate of return, IRR in Excel, is one of the built-in function available in Microsoft Excel. IRR on Excel falls under the category of financial functions in financial function. So this basically we are talking about. The internal rate of return is the rate of interest that is received for the investment done. So IRR in Excel consists of payments done represented by the negative values and the income generated denoted by positive values that occurs at the regular time of interval. So you can say that IRR function in Excel returns the internal rate of return for a series of cash flows represented by you can say positive and negative numbers, positive and negative numbers both. This cash flow does not have to be consistent as they would be for an annuity. However, the cash flow must, this is very important, must occur at a regular interval, such as like monthly, you can say quarterly and annually. So this has to be there. The cash amount can vary for each interval. So let's learn the IRR formula in Excel. As you can see, so the IRR formula is equal to IRR. As you can see over here, the returns, the internal rate of return for a series of the cash flow. Okay. Well, once you do that, you get values and guess. So the range or the value, this is basically the required parameter, this thing. And a range of cells that denote the series of cash flow for which the internal rate would be calculated. Now there is another thing that is called guess. Now what is this guess? This is an optional parameter. As you can see this is compulsory, but this is optional. It denotes a number that you guess is close to the result of the internal rate of return. So if the value mentioned, it takes a default value as a 0.1 or 10%, right? And the open bracket over here, this two bracket, they denote the optional parameters. Okay. So the function returns the numerical value, and it could be positive or it can be negative. So how to calculate this IRR in Excel? See, the IRR calculation in Excel can be done in two ways. That is based on worksheet, and second is by VBA function in Excel. Okay, VBA function. As a WS, that is worksheet function, it can be entered as a part of the formula in a cell, just like what we did right now of a worksheet. As a VBA function, it can be used in macros. This can be used in macros, specifically code which is entered through the Microsoft Visual Basic Editor integrated into MS Excel. Okay, refer to the IRR calculation in the template which is provided. Okay, and now the first, what we are going to do, we are going to start with the IRR calculation with the help of in worksheet, that is WS. So IRR calculation, first example. Now in the IRR calculation, let's say there are number of cash flows. Let's say there is minus 3000, then you have 2000, and then you have 5000. So how will you calculate IRR? It is as simple as that. I'm just calculating over here, is equal to IRR, and you select all of this three, that is the value C5 to C7. That's it. 67% is your IRR. So in this IRR example calculation, this 3000 over here, this basically minus 3000 denotes the capital amount invested. The subsequent 2000 and 5000 denotes the income. So this 2000 and 5000, they denote the income. So the IRR function in Excel is calculated on the values of minus 3000, 2000 and 5000, so which we get the result as 67%. Let's take another example of IRR. That is the same thing, but we'll take another example. Now let's see, in the IRR example, we'll be using three numbers. Let's say 3000, 2000 and 5000. So let's try and calculate a IRR with this numbers is equal to IRR and close the bracket. We get num error. Why do we get num error? So in this IRR example in calculation, the num is displayed as result because there is no single negative value present in the set of, in this particular set, there is no single negative value. So there is no value indicating the payment, but all are incomes because those all are positive. Let's take another example with three different numbers. Let's say third, that is minus 3000. Let's take another details, minus 3000, minus 2000 and minus 5000. Let's take this numbers and calculate the IRR. So once we do IRR calculation, close the bracket, we get again the num error. So in this IRR calculation, all the values over here, they are negative. This indicates that there was no income generated. Hence the result generated in is num. Let's take another one more example. That is this one is equal to, let's say there are a couple of cash flows that is available with us. The first is minus 10,000. Then we have 2,000, let's say 5,000, 4,000 and 6,000. These are the incomes and this is the outgoing. So let's calculate the IRR up to third year. Let's say this is the IRR. So we get minus 19% at the end of the third year. Let's calculate IRR at the end of the fourth year. When is the IRR getting positive? That's what we are looking for. Again, so it's getting positive 4%. And let's calculate the final IRR. If we calculate this, we get 22%. So in this IRR example calculation, the total values are minus 10,000. That denotes the payment done. These are the values per year, incomes earned like 2000, 5000, 4000 and 6000. So to calculate the income generated at the end of the 3 years, the IRR formula is applied in the cells that have been ranging. The result over here, that is minus 19%, as the payment amount in the initial year is more than this two, right? Is more than the income generated in the subsequent year. To calculate the income generated in at the end of the 5 years, the IRR formula is applied on the cells ranging, okay, which we get 4%, C2 to C28 and C25, sorry, C25 to 28 and 25 to 29. So the result is positive as the income generated in the following year is completely more than the payment amount invested in the initial year. As you can see, this is 11,000 and over here, this is more 17,000, which have crossed the line. Now, there are a couple of things that you should take in mind while calculating the IRR. First, the value of an array, it must contain at least one minimum positive, or you can say positive and negative, or negative, positive and one negative. Okay, this is the first criteria. The value should be in a sequential order. An IRR uses the order of the values to interpret the order of the cash flow. So please take care of that, you know, entering the payment and income values in the sequence as they happen or you desire to make it happen. The third, if an array of a reference or the argument contains text logical values or empty cells, those values are particularly ignored. Fourth, MS Excel uses an iterative technique calculate to IRR with Excel. So starting with guess. Fourth, the MS Excel uses an iterative technique to calculate IRR with Excel. Starting with guess, IRR cycle through the calculation until the result is accurate within the range of 0.401%, right? And if the IRR cannot find a result that works after 20 tries, then the num error will be returned. So if an IRR function is an Excel returns the num, or if the result is, you can say, is expected to be, then try with different values for. Sixth, in most of the cases, you need not provide guess value for the IRR calculation in Excel. So if the guess parameter is skipped, the software assumes it to be 0.1 or 10%. So that is the difference. IRR is closely related to NPV. If you try and have a look, the rate of return calculated by IRR with Excel is the interest rate corresponding to a zero net present value.